Alright, here we are. Now we got internet service now. So I got some military plates on order for my car, and I had the power bill that I just paid to hook my power up for $528 just went negative in my account. So that tells me that those trust checks, when they're given to the grocery stores don't have some necessary power to withdraw the money out of your accounts. But the utility companies do. Okay? So they'll take whatever you got in there and take it out, and the account will go into the negative balance. Now, not to worry. Not to worry. Okay? Oh, man. There we go. Yeah. So not to worry. Remember, launch your Polaris missile. When your heart starts to sink, you say, no, say, there's nothing to worry. Nothing to worry. Pull yourself out of it. You have to pass the test. Now you just got to think to yourself, okay, well, what's the next step that I need to do? So just sit and think. And for me, in my heart's telling me, with all the signs of Mother Nature showing me, that everything's going to be just fine and dandy. Fine and dandy. I will rise. And I will come out stronger in this situation. Right? And I will access that account. Yeah, that's the unlimited bond. I will have access. So, what it's made me want to do, I went down to my bank, and I went in there and I asked to talk to the biggest person they have around here in the area. And the manager of the bank said, well, what's it about? And I said, well, it's a private matter. She says, she kept saying, well, what's it about? And I said, it's private. And so she finally said, you know, I said, can I have his name and his contact? And she said, no. I said, the only way they can contact you. I said, well, I'll give you my email and you have her contact or him contact me. And she says, okay. And we were both happy and I left and all that. But I can already see that the signs that that the universe was giving me was speak to the chief financial officer. So I had forgot about that. But when I came home, I had some papers on the table and it said chief financial officer. And I said, oh, yeah, that's right. You want to keep things private, but you want to go all the way to the top and you want to talk to the bankers at the top. And that's going to be your executive vice presidents or your president or your chief financial officers all the way at the top. So I'm going to kind of wait for this email for the local bank here in the city, and I'll talk to her through email, and I'll see if I can get some information to take me to the chief financial officer. Because the chief financial officer is the one that we can talk to and say, hey, I've got a lien in the system. I said, no courthouse can touch me. No bank can touch me. Nobody can touch me unless I break the peace. Okay. So I would like to set up my private account and get things rolling here. And so that's my next move now. Now, as you can see, I've been heavy on manifesting this. Heavy on manifesting it. I thought it was all good with my trust checks that I put in. But it's just taking me to the next step. So, in fact, we don't even know what's going to happen next. But I'm saying to myself, I have to compose myself and say, whoa, relax. Everything's going to work out just fine and dandy. Fine and dandy. Right? Yeah. Got to relax. Got to breathe. We got to pay attention to Mother Nature around us, to our surroundings. It's a balance of being in mind and out of mind. Yes, it's relax. So the fear thoughts wanted to come into my mind and say, oh no, I went down to the local insurance agency and I wrote them a check for insurance. And I took that insurance proof and I went to the DMV and I ordered military plates for my car. So I was in the Navy. So, so they gave me a permanent or a temporary sticker to put on my back window. And they said, take your plates off your car. So I said, all right, not a problem. So now that I had a big check, just go negative in my account, I'm thinking, oh man, cops are going to come get me because their word's going to get around that my insurance check's bad. And then my the DMV is going to say, oh, shoot, we're not going to send him no plates. In fact, we're going to send the cops after him and all that. But not to worry. Not to worry. Then the other thought came in and said, whoa, wait a minute, you're military. Not only are you military, you're private military. And everybody around here in the city knows it. See, that's the advantage when you go out in your backyard and you become a crier in the backyard. You put everything in the public record verbally in the backyard because word gets around. See? That's very essential. I'm finding it's very essential for your city that you're in to go out in the backyard and you post it publicly with your voice in your backyard. Monitor with your neighbors because you don't want to disturb your neighbors, but it ain't no different from plugging in your own radio and listening to some other guy on the radio talk on the radio and you have it turned up in the backyard while you're doing yard work. It's the same thing. You're just naturally doing it verbally. So when you do your radio show, you tell everyone exactly what you're doing with your radio show. And you keep repeating it and repeating it and repeating it. So this way you get a reputation in the city. And all the people all of a sudden start have to say, whoa, we better not cause any public hazard here with this man who has an authentic lien on the public record, all recognized all the way at the top of the chain of command in the cities and the courts, sheriffs and the cops and the federal marshals, everything, all the way up to the state attorney general and the governors. All the way up to Washington, D.C., all the way to the world court. I know my stuff is recognized worldwide because of what I'm doing, the way I'm doing it here. And that's just my natural instinct to do it that way. So I know everything's going to be just right. It's just a matter of me finding the correct channels so that I can connect the circuit and have everything done privately, because we don't want to startle a lot of these guys at the lower ends in the banks. We don't want to startle them with start going in with information that they don't know nothing about. They won't know what to do with it at all. They won't. And so you really don't want to startle them, but you can if you want, because it's not a big deal, because people are going to find this information out anyway. So it's just as well that you talk to them about it anyway. It really ain't that big a deal. It's all a matter of what your conscience is telling you also. And you'll know right there in the spur of the moment what you need to do. When you start to do your studies of how to join Eastern and Western religions together to find the middle of the balance. So that's essential also to learning private maritime law. Because all of private maritime law is patterned after universal law, which is natural law also. Think on these things. So, here I am, I'm happy, I'm glad. Look, I got power on, I got nothing to be sad and fearful about. These are steps in the right direction. Look, I've manifested power in my house, I've manifested water. I need a new water heater though, because it broke. Because the pipe broke last year, and it probably did something with the with the heating elements inside the tank, so, because it, they got power to them, but they're not heating up. I stuck a meter on them. 220 volts are coming into it, but they're just not heating up. So now my next step, I'm going to go out and I'm going to write another check for a water heater and see who's going to take it. Now, I went to Macintosh store last night and I tried to buy $5,000 worth of brand new computer equipment. But they said the check was denied because of an overdraft. And now I figured it out. It was because the utility company went into my account and overdrew the account. So remember, don't get mad at them. Don't blame at them. Remember, everything is a test from Mother Nature. All this is just a universal path of getting to where we need to go. So if we can realize that everything is just lining up like ducks in a row for the things that we need to get trained in, that the universe, ruled by our own thoughts, connected with our hearts. Our hearts know that, yes, I need to go through this. I need to learn this. I need to know this. And in my heart, the way I operate, I forcefully put myself in situations on purpose with no fear. And sometimes with fear, but for the most part, I pull myself out of it. And I know that, hey, deep in my heart and in my conscience, I know my holy of holy, the most high thoughts. I know this is what's going to take to get me there. So I do things to force myself into doing something. Otherwise, if I just sit back and do nothing, just watch everything, I won't get anything done. So I'm one of those persons that has to just go out there and just do a bunch of things, throw a bunch of seed out in the field, and see what grows. That's just the way I see myself sometimes. You know, because I get overexcited sometimes about, you know, new ideas, like this trust check that I have. Because when I heard about this trust check, how to write it and everything, I was like, I knew within my spirit, this is it. This is it. All right? I know everything's going to go. It might not go exactly how I thought it would go. Right? Because my mind is not yet fully developed to even manifest myself, to even change form yet. So I can't control my destiny that much yet. But I do have some control, right? And I know what my goal is that I want to have to do. So sometimes we think everything's going to come down and it's going to work a certain way, and it doesn't. Not yet, anyway. We can eventually get to that goal where everything we think will manifest just exactly as we think it would. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. But until such time as we get there, we have to take what's called the compromising routes. And that's, you know, that's the law of negotiating. Because of our weakened condition. We're not fully strong, powerful, thoughtful people walking the earth yet. Otherwise, if we were, we could morph into different bodies just like that. Boom. See what I'm saying? Oh, you'll climb. Get up on that pulpit and get down with your little Pinocchio. Put some strings on your arms and all that. Whing, 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 whing. Whatever you need to do, you know. But you just got to do what you got to do to get free. If it takes you turning on your power and your internet and your life and everything just to have a little bit of freedom just to get you so you can let out and let loose, you know, turn around, do some dancing, spin around, you know, drop your tape measure on the ground a little bit, put in your pocket, swing those hips around, get a little thing, throw some guitar on, do what you got to do, man, you know, loosen yourself up, do whatever it takes to loosen yourself up, and don't be ashamed of your own moves and everything. The way your body was made, the way it moves and all that, you know. Hey, man, we all got a bunch of things in common. We all do all kinds of all these different moves. And some of us are skilled in doing different moves more than others because we practice those moves all the time. See what I'm saying? So, so here we are. We're still in the house and everything. Everything's going to be just fine and dandy. All right, so that'll be it for this report. I think I might want to play a little guitar now. All right.